Hello my fellow board gamers, this is Lamf Games, a board game publishing company in the making, and if I look a little bit different right now, it's because before I went to GenCon, I was recording something and I accidentally dropped my camera and I broke my $350 lens.
I'm stupid!
Now, if the quality of this video is not as good as before, I'm gonna be pissed because I broke my $350 lens. Now, if the quality is as good as before, I'm gonna be pissed because that means I didn't need to buy my $350 lens. Either way, there's no making me happy.
I can't seem to get happy. Maybe this will help.
If I look a little different because I broke my $350 lens. By the way, if you're enjoying these videos, please subscribe because we need to feed the algorithm gods.
The science seems so solid.
Thank you so much. But what are we here to talk about? We're here to talk about GenCon, which happened 1 week ago or 2 weeks ago, depending on your perception of time. But before we talk about GenCon, let's talk about Dice Tower East, because I went to Dice Tower East before we went to GenCon and I didn't make a video about it. Now, Dice Tower East is a much, much, much smaller convention, but it was so much fun because we didn't really spend as much time walking in the exhibition area. We actually spent all the time playing games, and it was funny because my girlfriend and I are mainly like midway to light gamers, and the first thing that she did when we walked into the convention was like, let's play Return to the Dark Tower. And that was a 2-hour game. We ended up losing, but honestly it was so fun and it was way easier than I thought it would be with all the miniatures and the tower. You have to download an app, like it's like a 3-step thing on your turn and that's it. Like, it's super simple and the app also tells you what's going on. Like, it was a lot of fun and I can't wait to play it again. We play tested Fluffy Dragons with around 30 to 35 people. We got 25 new people on the email list and we met so many cool people at Dice Tower East and we played a lot of games with them. And it was funny because we actually met a lot of them also at Gen Con. Now back to Gen Con, we drove there, although that's probably the last time that we're gonna do that. We didn't have any car issues like we did last year, but it did take us 13 hours to get there and 17 hours to get back, because on the way back I couldn't sleep, but then I was too tired to drive. And my girlfriend keeps reminding me about this every single day since we got back. And
I'm just talking about me.
I'm recording. Every day since we got back. I'm recording. But what can I say, that it's not just better for me to show you all the different videos that we got at the convention. It took us 2 whole days to walk the whole exhibition area. It's gigantic. There are so many booths, there are so many artists, there are so many board game companies that we have seen before, some that we had never seen before. The demo hall was gigantic as well. There were so many games being played there. They had a lot of rooms at the Marriott across the street. It takes like 20 minutes to get there because, again, the whole thing is huge. They had a stadium for the library. I'm pretty sure they were doing tournaments over there too. There were so many events that we went to, there were so many events that we heard about afterwards, and there were so many people at Gen Con. I heard that it was between 85 to 90,000 people that attended, although then I read reports that it was a little bit less, but either way it was packed and it was really hard to walk through all the people. And a lot of those people were content creators, and there were content creators from all over the place. So there were content creators from every state, from every, there were a lot of people from all over the world. And it was so cool because We met many of them, we hang out with many of them, we played games with many of them, we ate with many of them. We even got kicked out of a party because me personally, I wasn't invited to the party. But I knew a lot of people that were in the party, and we went with people that were invited to the party. But yeah, they told me that they were at capacity and it was late. Our hotel was like 40 minutes away and it was like, you know what, like, just go.
We're obviously okay. Not wanted here, okay. So let's get the hell out.
We even got kicked out of a party. We bought so many games. Oh, I forgot about that. We got around 21 games, which honestly, since we're gonna drive next year, it's gonna make it easier for us to not buy games because we won't have a trunk on a car to put them in, and we have to be thinking about the weight of the luggage. But since next year we're not gonna do that, then whatever, this was fun. Like one last year, we won last, like, let's just buy all the games that we want to. And there were a few that we wanted to buy too, but they were sold out. So yeah, we probably would have bought around 25 games. And now from the top. Oh my god, it's hot. And at this convention, I didn't actually get to play Fluffy Dragons with a lot of people. I got to play with two people and one of them signed up for the email list. But as I think I said last year, Gen Con is mainly a convention to buy games and to meet people, in my opinion. And that's mainly what we did. We could have signed up for the first exposure playtest hall like we did last year, but I mean, you can go watch that video. I don't think that's a good room for short games, and mine is a short game, so yeah. So yeah, that was my experience at Dice Tower East and Gen Con. And if you're enjoying these videos, please like them to feed the algorithm gods.
Yes, science!
Also, on the last video, I was talking about the art development. We had finished the blue dragon. Since then, we finished the white dragon. We're currently working on the pink dragon, and I will talk more about the art development on the next video. And if you want to see more about the journey of designing my first board game and creating my board game publishing company, watch some of these videos. And yeah, thank you so much for watching. Have a wonderful day. Take care. Bye. Thank you so much for watching. Have a nice day.